seconds. The red rise as they go out. We get a great start there from Danny Pedrosa. But Marc Marquez was hot. And
Maverick.
Interesting to know what tyres are on the Tech 3 there on the number 5. I've got to say, I think I saw that they were going for mediums. Come to us. Of course, it's a late comer for us as up the inside comes. Yep, that time. Anything you can do, I can do better. And pushing Jorge Marquez, Iannone, Crutchlow, Vinales, Zarco, Rossi in 7th place, Lorenzo in 8th place. Jack Miller had his finest dry weather qualifying.
And he's just gone past Lorenzo, and Lorenzo was wide in turn 1. Jack's trying to find a way through, but Lorenzo's only
gone for the half front back, so has Marquez. They are the standouts of the entire field.
There wasn't the Brandon Agio with the old up-high conference ball. There was not a medium of time as they go over the line this time. On the over.
On board with Jorge.
Lorenzo on 7-4.
Interesting as well, isn't it? Look at the way. Oh, look at that. Ducati. Dobby's in front of Rossi. It's only a matter of time, as we were sort of alluding to, that Dobby, when he's there and he's got this kind of pace, he is a bit relentless. Looks so smooth, Dobby. He doesn't look like he's fast, does he?
That's Dobby.
Maybe it's a mistake.
Why?
Yeah, Rossi made a mistake. Through has gone. Dobby at bay.
All medium tyres in that picture. Front and rear for both of them.
Ducati. Will they stay with him? Yeah, that's a bit more like a Ducati. Up the side, Dolphy. Tech 3. Got to do it on the brakes. Zarco is sharp. He tries to tough it out there, Jorge. But Jorge was filling the gap. Big crowd. Big applause for the move in front of them in that amphitheatre out there.
Good position for the Ducati. And the Ducati of Jorge Lorenzo.
They will be smiling if they manage to put that on the podium, though.
Ducati fans, Jorge fans, I suggest you step up and cheer.
Qualified in the middle of the third row, the best Ducati. He's had front rows here since his 250 days in 2000. People don't think they have grip if they're not black for some reason or another. So it's a marketing
novelty plastic.
Yeah, and they don't have any grip as they got colour. Apparently it's not a major problem to do. I'm still
three Yamahas fighting Ducatis.
Turn two being Michelin corner.
Yeah, he's gone. He didn't make a mistake because the vector spent constant so far around this lap. James Toseland must be very confident. Rossi absolutely in the walls with the front end of his motorcycle.
And that will go for all weekend. Look at my
aspect, the front of the boat and the Yamaha. Johan Zarco, a rookie, a satellite team rider, can see, can smell a loss from finish.
Tell you what,
in his fourth race in his heart.
For day one, he has not looked like a rookie on that GP bike. There is no time that I've looked at Johan Zarco for a rookie. So his tactics, the way he's prepared to stick it in, everything he's done. Seeing the way Jorge was making progress, we're going to have a big play on him. So he's in the money.
Get no off now, am I?
No, he had any left on the Hodgie got here.
No, he did to save up.
Well, right. With Jorge Lorenzo, you're right. Great ride, great performance. Ducati, team thing after all. They're working hard to make this work.